goodness. Oh, my head itches so much. It itches. It itches. Hey everybody, how you guys doing? My name is Tiffany E of PsychDesignTV. How y'all doing? How y'all doing? How y'all doing? How y'all doing? Today we're gonna do a review of this Betty here. Y'all see it? Side profile. Bam. Hit it. Vogue. Anyway, we're gonna do a review of this wig here. So let's jump into me trying to get this thing on my head and what I had to do to get it on there. And then we're gonna give you the rest of this review. TT, come rap with me right quick. What's with all the head? Listen, I saw a wig that I thought was really cute on the model, and I'm like, can I pull that off? And I can. So let me show you what it looks like on the model. What I ordered. I ordered her. Her name is Nadi. And this is by Sensationnel, and this is a part of their Empress Lace Wig line. And of course, it's got a little side part going on, okay? Now, I will say this. My part does not look the greatest because my hair is coming out right there, and you can tell. If I pull it forward, the part won't lay right, and it's already not laying right, so I had to lay it like that, and what I can do is take my makeup brush and kind of shift my hair out of the way and make like a faux part. So what it'll look like, see it'll lay better right there. Okay, so it lays a little bit better now that I moved the hair out of the way. Let's get into the logistics of this wig. So this is supposed to be a natural curved part wig. It's a curling wig, so you can curl it. It's up to 300, it goes from 350 to 400 degrees for curling iron safe. This is the F1B30 color, so it's a 1B base and it's got 30 streaks in it. As far as the color is concerned, I love the color. The hair itself is super soft, don't have any issues with the structure. The cap. I had to put the straps on the last set of straps, and then this particular wig, the strap, there's only two notches on each side of where the straps are. So the cap ain't that big, mommy. So you might want to be careful. If you a big-headed chick like me, you be careful when you order this, my G. Like, you need to be real, real careful. So this wig can be worn several ways. It can be worn as a full lace front like what I'm wearing it. as, or you can wear this as a U-part wig and pull part of your hair out, which is what the demonstration on the back of the card is telling you you can do. And because it's kind of a curved C-part, you can take out some of your hair and, you know, blend it in and make it look nice. And it'll probably sit better if it's a U-part wig, but because I'm wearing it as a full lace front wig, we're gonna have to just test this out as is. So, style-wise, I actually love this. I thought it was a little bit more glamorous than I am used to, but ooh, I like that. I don't know why, I just do. Let's put that on my eye though. First, we gotta get that shaped back. Get this shape back. Now we can kind of do some damage because my edge is not out. Oh, looking very Janet Jackson-y. Okay. Alright, come on. Come on, girls. Work with me. Okay. That'll work. That's cute. Okay. So because some of my hair is out, I can kind of make it look a little different and leave that open and not have to cover up everything. But it's still heavy on this side with the curls and a little bit more laid on this side. And I wish this one's a little bit more shaped like that. But there's not really much I can do about it. Besides leave it in my face and kind of push it up a little bit. And let it be the focal point. I'm like so lost as to what to do with this. I have to figure this out while I'm talking to y'all. That actually isn't bad. That works. I like this. Okay, so how do I like this wig? I stepped outside my comfort zone and I wish I could go back in it. I don't really like curly wigs like this because they require a lot of maintenance, a lot of shaping, and when you buy them, you know, you think that they will sit on your head right, you think that it will look right, and a lot of times it's a catch 22 and you're just like, like, it looks so good on the model and it doesn't look like that on me. Like, a straight wig, you can get away with. Anybody can wear a straight wig, but a curly wig, you gotta have some serious skills to make these wigs work out in your favor, okay? So, for a novice, I wouldn't suggest you go out and buy this wig. I would suggest you buy something that's more in your speed. Get you something that's maybe a little bit more wavy, a little bit more on the length. Get you something that's straight, a blunt cut bob or something like that for a novice wig wearer. This right here will have you out of your mind trying to figure out how to get this to work on your head. Unless you're a fast learner and you know how your hair should look with these kinds of looks, or you have this kind of hair, or you have a daughter with this kind of hair, or you just know how to style this kind of hair. I like the curls. I like the style of it. I like what they were trying to do in terms of the concept. A lot of girls who are natural want this kind of a curl when they do their hair and they just can't achieve this. I don't know. I feel like it doesn't make me look older. And for this is what, that's what I first thought. I'm like, this made me look so much older. But it don't make me look older. It does give me kind of a regal thing. I do look regal, you know, my misshapen shirt. But we're not talking about that. We're talking about my hair. So, it do give me kind of, you know, bald hair, regal vibe. It do give me that. But other than that, I could take it or leave it. It's no big deal. Yeah. That's pretty much it. Let's run it down. Let's run down the specs again, just to be clear.
as saved. This is a curly wig. It can be curled from 350 to 400 degrees. This is by Sensationnel and it's a part of their Empress lace wig line. This wig is called Nadi and it's a F1B30. I got it from wigtypes.com, which is where I get all of my wigs from. Since I can't remember the price, I'll put the price in here somewhere. It is a natural curved part. It can be worn as a wig, as a lace wig, or you can wear it as a U-part. You just have to cut down the middle where the lace part is and open it up, and then you can wear your some of your hair out. So it comes in a variety of special colors, as well as the standard 1, 1B2, 4, you know, that kind of stuff. This right here, it was a challenge for me. It wasn't absolutely terrible, but it was a challenge to pull this look off. And I never have that much trouble with a wig, but this one was, it was one of them, Okay, so you're gonna give me that kind of trouble. All right. Like, I didn't have to fight with her too much, but it was something of a challenge to get her to sit the way I wanted her to sit on my head. Plus, another downside, as I said before, is the cap. The cap on this is really small. And if you have a big head, it's going to be difficult for you to situate this on your head right. And one thing about this wig is you need to get your the placement of your part correct, and you need to have your hair laid down properly so the wig sits right, because this part is sitting up on me because this is where my braid is. If my hair wasn't in the way, the part would probably sit down properly. When I bought it, I initially bought this in this mix. I liked that 1B. I thought with this kind of hair that it would work out in my favor, and it did. I like the color payoff of everything. It's really pretty. Would I recommend this wig to you and everybody else who watches my channel? Yes and no. Yes, because I love the texture of the wig. It is super soft. It is not itchy. It's a great wig. Yes, because the price on it is really nice. It's not super expensive and it's not super pricey for a brand named wig either. It's pretty reasonable in the price range. Yes, because of the style. The style is beautiful. The curls in this are absolutely gorgeous. It flows really nicely and it snaps back really cool. So yes, because of those things, but no, because this is going to require a lot of fiddling with. It's going to require you to do a lot of work to get this shaped for your face and for you, the way you like to look. So if you have a particular way that you like to wear your wigs, this wig is going to give you some trouble, because especially if you don't like hairing your face, it just works better when the hair is down like this. But for me, it does, and I like the way that looks. But for you, you know, you might have an issue with the hair being in your face, or with the curl pattern. You might have an issue with the fact that you have to do so much manipulation to get this thing to sit on your head right. You may have issues with that. So no on that front, but yes on the other. So the yes outweighs the no's. So I would say yes, reluctantly. I would recommend this wig to you, but if you are a novice wig wearer and you're not really keen on how to style a wig to suit you and to wear and frame your face, then I would not suggest this wig. I would suggest you pick a different wig, probably a longer, curlier wig, and or maybe a longer, more wavy wig. I have a couple wig reviews that I can put in a playlist with this one to let you guys, you know, see what I mean. But yeah, so that's that. So I know it wasn't the greatest, you know, review of a curly wig that we can give, but mama tried. She tried so hard and she's so tired. I'm just so tired. I'm so tired. Y'all rate, comment, and subscribe. Let me know what you think about this wig. Comment in the comment section below. And if you like this wig, if you want more wigs like this, I will do more wigs like this. Child. But I really don't want to. Because this is what I had to cut off to get this thing to work for me. But anyways, like I said, rate, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. And please, please share my videos. Comment on my videos. Just engage with me, okay? I really want to know who's out there watching my videos. Who's out there, you know, thumbs up in my video. And who's putting the thumbs down. Tell me why you don't like my videos, okay? Tell me why y'all like them. We can battle this ish down. You feel me? Like, I'm just saying, I want to engage with my people. I don't mind you telling me some constructive criticism. But if it's just you going to be like, you know, you a fat bitch and I don't like your videos, but you sit there and watch them, then you can keep that comment to yourself, bruh. You feel me? Anywho, rate, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.